Hello students, this is Nitin Mohod, and here in this video we are going to discuss about variable capacitors. In the previous videos we have already seen the fixed capacitors and their types. Fixed capacitors were the capacitors in which the capacitance of the capacitor was fixed, but here in variable capacitors the capacitance can be varied. That is only the difference basically. Now in the picture you can see the single block of variable capacitors, which is consisting of two sets of metal plates separated by an air. So this is one set of metal plates and this is the second set. Now this set of plate is a stator plates because it's a stationary, it's a fixed. So stationary or fixed set of plates called stator. And that's why these are the stator plates, and this is insulated from the frame upon which it is mounted, while the another set of plates, which you can see here, is connected to this shaft and can be rotated like this or like this, and hence they are called as rotor plates. Thus capacitance can be changed by rotating the shaft. Means when this shaft will be rotated in clockwise direction, these rotating plates will be moved into these plates, and when it will be moved in anti-clockwise, these plates will be moved out of the stator plates. On rotating rotor with suitable knob, rotor plates can be moved in or out of the stator plates. These are the rotor plates and these are the stator plates. Maximum capacitance is obtained when rotor plates are fully in and minimum when fully out, and hence from the situation which is shown in the picture right now, it is clear that the capacitance existing here is minimum because the rotor plates are fully out of the stator plates. And when the situation will be reversed, it means when these plates will be moved into this by rotating this shaft, means when these rotor plates will be fully in the stator plates, at that time you will get the maximum capacitance. If n are the total number of plates and d is the separation between any two adjacent plates, then capacitance for air dielectric, as you can see there is nothing in between the two adjacent plates, that's why we are saying the air dielectric. So under such circumstances, the capacitance for air dielectric will be given as C is equal to n minus 1 epsilon 0 A upon D farads. We have already seen all these parameters in the previous videos and their importance. Two or more such capacitors, now here only single section is shown. If two or more such capacitors are operated using a single shaft, then it will be called as the gang capacitors. Now we will see here a pictorial representation of the gang capacitor. Here you can see the fixed plates. These are actually the sets of the fixed plates, and the movable plates or rotor plates are here, which are connected to a single spindle or single knob, you can say. It's also called air capacitor. Since the air is the dielectric, there is nothing as such dielectric provided in between the adjacent plates, since dielectric used here is air. Air gap between plates is fixed while the plate area is variable. Plate area means plate overlapping area is variable. It has two sets of plates. One is stationary or stator, which are fixed. So these are the fixed plates of set. Fixed set of plates. And the second is secondary set, connected to the shaft or rotor, or you can say to the spindle as shown in the figure. Capacitance is changed by moving rotor plates with the help of spindle. So when this spindle will be moved like this, then these plates will move in a circular way, and accordingly there is overlapping area which will change, and the capacitance of the capacitor will change. For tuning type, means adjusting type, their values ranges from 15 farad to 500 farad. temperature coefficient of such gang capacitor is around 120 parts per million per degree Celsius, and operating voltage range is up to 750 volts DC. It is used in broadcast receivers and oscillator resonating circuits. Then coming on to trimmer capacitors, which are also called as trimmers. Plate area is fixed, but the gap between the plate is variable. Now here you can see, this is one plate which is movable, and this is the fixed plate which is called as the stator plate or stationary plate, and this is the rotor plate, or not you can say rotor, but here you can see it's a movable plate. And this is the plastic film provided in between, and it's a screw provided which can be turned from this side. Two flexible plates are separated by air, mica or plastic, as you can see here, plastic, that is PVC film, as a dielectric. With the screw adjustment, the gap between the plate is changed. So when you will move this screw like this in a clockwise direction, this plate will come down and the distance between these two plates will be lesser or will reduce. So with the screw adjustment, the gap between the plate is changed. Plastic film trimmer capacitor is as shown, which is also called as plastic cored capacitor. Range of the capacitance value in such type of capacitor is from 4.7 picofarads to maximum of 30 picofarads. Plastic cored capacitors are small compared to air cored type and used in modern radios for tuning purpose. Tuning means adjusting the stations in case of radios. Now the difference we are going to see, the trimmers and padders. There is a very very small difference between the trimmers and padders. They are basically the synonym like we are using, and that's why we are saying the trimmers or padders. Trimmers, the variable capacitors often used in parallel with main variable capacitors, sometimes called as the padders, used for fine adjustments on total capacitance of the device. Means when very less adjustment of the capacitance has to be done, that is done with the help of these padders. It consists of two small flexible metal plates separated by air, mica or ceramic slab as a dielectric. Spacings between these plates can be adjusted using screw adjustments, as we have seen already. Plates are compressed if the screw turns inward and capacitance increases, and exactly opposite will happen if the screw is turned outward. Trimmers and padders are mostly similar in appearance, except that a padder may be larger or have more number of plates. This is only the difference. Capacitance of trimmer can be changed from 5 picofarads to maximum of 30 picofarads, while padder capacitance can be changed from 10 picofarads to 500 picofarads. This is one more difference you can see. Variable capacitors are mainly used as timing capacitors in radio receivers, which are providing the proper timing. Tuning the radio station means adjusting or actually varying the capacitance. Voltage rating of the capacitor. This is one of the most important parameters associated with capacitors. And what it is? It is the maximum voltage that can be applied across its plates without puncturing the dielectric. The ratings are related to 60 degrees Celsius, while higher temperature reduces the voltage ratings. For paper, mica and ceramic capacitors, voltage ratings are 200 volts to 500 volts DC. Ceramic capacitors with voltage ratings 1K to 12 kV are also available. Electrolytic capacitors are used in 25 150 and 450 volts rating. So these are the varied voltage ratings in which the electrolytic capacitors are used. Ratings for AC voltage are somewhat less because of heat produced due to continuous charging and discharging, since AC flows in both the directions. For the half cycle, it flows in one direction. For the negative half, it flows in another direction. We are showing here some capacitors with their ratings and how they are shown. So voltage ratings of the capacitors, generally they are marked like this, 223. Now what it means actually, it is 22 into 10 raised to power 3 into 10 raised to power minus 12 farads. Or if you reduce this, it will be 22 into 10 raised to power minus 9, that is equal to 22 nanofarads. So 223, if this is written on this type of capacitors, then it will be read as 22 nanofarad. Second example, 22, just 22 written there over there means 22 into 10 raised to power minus 12 farads. So it's simply 22 picofarads. Then 3K3. So here K stands for kilo ohms. So 3.3 kilo ohms into 10 raised to power minus 12 farads. That gives 3.3 nanofarads. Then 33K. So here 33 into 10 raised to power 3 into 10 raised to power minus 12. That gives 33 nanofarads. Then 0.1. So it represents in microfarad directly, 0.1 microfarads. 0.01, it represents 0.01 microfarad, and 0.47, so it will definitely going to represent 0.47 microfarad. I hope the idea about these variable capacitors, their types, which we have seen in this video, along with the voltage rating parameter, is clear to you. Thank you.